Hi guys, Matt Schlick from ZapChain, and I'm here with Derek Minter, the co-founder of Honey Badger. They're the leading recruiters for the Bitcoin space. Welcome to the Bitcoin course.
Thanks, man. Thanks for having me. I'm excited to chat a bit.
Yeah, I mean, so Bitcoin is obviously, it can be super complicated in the beginning, and so we're helping all these amazing people watching right now learn more about Bitcoin.
Awesome.
So tell us a little bit about Honey Badger.
So like you said, we are building a recruiting platform for Bitcoin startups. We were kind of moved to get into the space after seeing the quality of talent that was already kind of getting involved and the quality of VC money going there. And so we're really focused on folks who aren't, haven't really proclaimed their interest yet in Bitcoin, but we've kind of made an assumption that people are playing around with it and doing work at night and moonlighting. So we want to create a platform that enables people to kind of let themselves be known or kind of make us aware, like, hey, I'm interested in this space, but I love my job. Right. Let me know when that match happens. So it's been a wild ride for us so far, but we've been really impressed with the interest that we've had so far from both sides.
Yeah, I mean, I've had so many people talk to me about Honey Badger,
and
they're like, "Yeah, Honey Badger." Whenever I leave my job, they're gonna go help me work at a Bitcoin company.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Let's take a step back from Honey Badger for a bit. So, like, you know, Bitcoin's been out for 5 years now, or a little over 5 years, but how did you originally hear about Bitcoin? And when you heard about it, was it like super confusing?
Yeah, I actually had just left Google and was working at a YC startup called CoderWall, and we were working on a recruiting platform there. So pretty early on when I started there, something about Bitcoin came up on Hacker News. And so me and the founder, Matt, spent some time over lunch, probably 30 minutes talking about it, and both of us left with our heads hurting. So that kind of planted the seed, but it was something it was almost too big to even try to tackle at that point. But it was one of those things that kind of, as I saw news kind of down the line, I was like, oh yeah, that it's kind of gaining some steam. And but yeah, it made my head hurt. For sure.
So, like, what, like, you went from going to Hacker News, which, for everyone that doesn't know, Hacker News is a really excellent collection of news articles submitted by and curated by, like, entrepreneurs and hackers and stuff. So, after you found out about Bitcoin on there, and it kind of blew your mind, I guess.
Yeah.
then, like, how did you get to going from there, you know, you were working at another company, to deciding to stop working there and actually go start a new company in the Bitcoin space?
Yeah. So it's actually interesting. Like, the moment that I had, like, my aha moment was just me recruiting for a startup in the city. And somebody's LinkedIn, John Waller, he's in Japan, I believe, now. But he's pretty, he's doing some cool stuff in the space. But anyways, I came across his profile, and it basically said, I'm interested in Bitcoin. If you don't know what this is, drop everything and read this article. And so it was an Eric Voorhees article that was really understandable. I think since then there's been a lot of material out there, and that kind of makes it easier, and, you know, some stuff like this. But yeah, I read that article and kind of had my first, like, whoa, that's a big moment. And from there, you know, I kind of sent it along to Josh, who's now one of my co-founders, and we both fell down the rabbit hole. So we spent probably 2 or 3 months. Like, first we started, you know, trading a little bit, but beyond that, we were kind of, it was an opportunity for us to kind of get technical. We're kind of wannabe nerds, and we always interact with so many smart people, and so, you know, it opened up a lot of doors for us, but lots of all-nighters trying to learn about it and understand the math behind it. And then you start to get beyond the money use case and see how much more that technology can do. So, after about 2 or 3 months, I actually it just had that moment of like, I can't work for anything else but Bitcoin. So there wasn't much at the time. I came across a Craigslist ad for one of the jobs that was actually here in at Boost with Snapcard. And I was like on the verge of saying, hey, let me work for free. I just want to be around a company. And so that kind of started a kind of exploration where I just got coffee with a founder. And he's like, dude, like, you get the blockchain thing. Like, you have a job here if you want it. I don't know what you do, but like, we struggle to find people who are passionate about this and that get it. So he's like, I would hire you right now, but let me do you a favor. You should start this company. I think it could be, it solve a lot of problems in the industry. So, it's been a wild ride ever since then.
Wow, and I guess maybe he kind of tricked you because he like needs to hire more people.
Right.
And so instead of bringing you on, he's like, how about you go like get money from investors and have them pay you and then help me, you know, hire more people.
Yeah. Well, it's funny. So he. That actually came up a little bit. He's like, I've never used recruiters. In your case, like, if you know, we could probably figure something out if you want to do this on the side. But so I think he could have gone that route. It was kind of cool. I think this speaks to the Bitcoin industry of it being a little bit. It's the most communal like technology I've seen. So it almost seems like in that moment he's like, I could have this recruiter, or they could build something really cool for the industry.
Like you, like Derek could improve the industry.
Right.
Like more if he started his own company.
Right, right.
That's pretty cool. What, like you've been in other industries, you know, like you were at Google, you know, you've worked with Y Combinator companies, now you're in Bitcoin.
Right.
Some of these other industries are exciting, right? But is there something different about Bitcoin? Like, are you noticing that, like, is it more exciting?
Yeah, so, you know, Bitcoin, like, Bitcoin startups face a lot of the same problems that any startup does. One thing that we're building off of is just recruiting is pretty broken in itself. It's a, you know, most engineers in the city are getting so much spam that it's just like a knee-jerk reflex to say, like, you're spamming me, screw off.
Like, go away.
Right.
Yeah.
So one thing when I was at CoderWall, we were trying to solve that problem for developers, and we were targeting a very high market or a very high caliber candidate, and we found that people, you know, that are making 160K at Google, for example, are willing to leave to maybe work at a charity or something. Like, they're pay requirement drops to 80K. So we saw this trend, and I think all the guys that are on the Honey Badger team, we've always been in a position where we can always win that war of like pay, benefits, all of that. You know, we've always been at companies that, if it's Google or Facebook, Ryan just left Facebook actually.
Ryan is another co-founder of Honey Badger.
Yeah. So, you know, we got a unique view that...
By the way, I like that you somehow, like, you're saying that you can get people to leave, like, these huge companies to go work at Bitcoin companies, and part of that is, like, you got someone to leave Facebook to go work at Honey Badger?
Yeah, so, that was a big win for us. We had our eyes set on Ryan for a bit, and we kind of had an experiment with him. Like, he was a little bit later to like starting to go down the rabbit hole, and Josh and I kind of said, like, when he's kicking our door down that he has to work in the space, like, we'll bring him on. Like, and so we basically made this bet of like, here's your material to read and you're smart enough to get it and have the aha moment. And it was really cool to see that over, you know, a month or two.
And like, you called it.
Yeah, it was great. All the bets of like the bets that we made on you know, smart people being the ones that are catching on first and getting it and dabbling right now, like, to see that firsthand on our own company is really cool.
So, like, when you're talking to someone, I mean, it's still like crazy actually that you can go talk to someone from like one of these major tech companies, which, I mean, everybody watching has heard of these companies. They use them every day, you know. And going to them and saying, hey, you know, maybe not leave now, but, like, if we have an opportunity and, like, there's an up-and-coming Bitcoin company that needs to hire someone like you, like, would you be interested in us, like, connecting you guys?
Right.
Like, the concept that most people in the world still think of Bitcoin as magic money, and they don't understand that it's not just a currency, and there's this huge, like, you know, protocol, which is the blockchain that's powering it, and that could, it could potentially change the world.
Right.
It's crazy that these people, these big tech companies are actually doing this.
Yeah. Yeah, so it, what's interesting about, like, how our sign-up flow goes, like, we get tons of folks who are interested in just anywhere in Bitcoin. Like, I want to be in the space. I don't necessarily care about this specific problem. But we've also had folks who are a little too early. Like, maybe they want to solve problems that just don't make sense yet. There's not enough infrastructure, but they're saying, like, hey, if you find a team that is solving this really specific problem, I want to hear about it. Like, I'm working on something similar now, and that's, like, the next transformative thing. And not only, you know, you think of, like, the technical side with, like, your, you know, Google, Facebook, Amazon, those big companies. There's also, we've seen quite a big interest from, you know, your major financial companies.
Right.
So, like, Visa and, you know, all the major banks, MasterCard. That's one thing that we didn't know exactly what to expect and hadn't really been involved in that space, but it's pretty cool to see the interest there. We've got quite a few folks that, you know, have tried to, like, make things move within their own company. I've said, all right, fine. If you guys aren't going to listen, like, I'm going to beat you. Like, you become kind of the enemy in a sense. So, so it's really cool to work with people like that. And these are folks that just, you know, whether they're too busy or, you know, are not interested in getting into the flow of interviewing, like, it seems like there's been a lot of value in enabling them to just, like, hey, do you want to have this intro with the founder for 15 minutes and kind of gain excitement there? So hopefully, you know, it's a benefit for not only candidates, but for founders who are able to sell their product up front, sell the vision, and we've been happy with the flow so far.
So if you're talking to someone and they've heard about Bitcoin, but maybe they haven't fallen down this, like, rabbit hole yet, you know, they haven't, like, gotten addicted to learning more about, like, Bitcoin.
Yeah.
Do you have, like, some places that you send them to? You're like, oh, okay, you're interested in Bitcoin. You're not sure if you want to go somewhere yet, but you want to learn more. You should go check out, like, this, this, and this.
Yeah, yeah. So it's kind of a tricky, like, selling Bitcoin to people is tough because it's, I think with a lot of technologies that are transformative and disruptive, you typically have people on either side of the extreme. Like, I either get it and I'm way into it, or, like, no, that's the stupidest idea ever. So, I feel like I was late to the game, but in my short time, it seems like if I sell too hard, people turn away from it. It's like, I don't know, it kind of, like, resonates like CrossFit does. I don't know if that's a good example, but just, like, it's promoted so much.
Right.
But as far as where I've sent people, there's a, I forget the name of the guy who wrote the blog, but it's, like, Explain Like I'm Five Bitcoin. It's on, it was a post on Medium that does a really good job explaining, like, basically it takes an apple and makes it a digital apple and kind of explains the, you know, the open ledger and all of that. That seems to, like, that's what I use with my mom. She kind of, like, got it. So I'm big on, like, the mom tests for people understanding, because my mom is pretty averse to technology, but
she was probably more confused after she read it too, which is kind of, I think, across the board, where it's like, someone's like, I don't understand Bitcoin at all. I'm going to go learn something about it. And then they, like, you read the first thing and you're like, nope,
yeah.
I know even less
yeah.
than I did, like, 10 minutes ago. I'm even more confused. Now I need to go learn more. And it, like, it just keeps
going. Yeah, I think, like, you just want, like, one, I think it can be a very small like moment of like, okay, maybe I get that concept a little bit. Maybe it's not the craziest thing in the world. Because like, I mean, I still kind of lovingly call it magic internet money. It is that crazy. Like, so I try to kind of plant the seed and get some, try to maybe understand a little, have someone understand a little concept and then kind of go from there. But there's just, the rabbit hole goes way down. Like, so if you try to explain all of that in one sitting, it's overwhelming. Yeah.
So when you're talking to these potential hires, I guess, that are working at these major companies, you mentioned that they, sometimes they're interested in doing things that maybe the industry's not quite ready for.
Right.
Do you have any, like, are there any examples? Because maybe someone watching could just go build that and you yeah. could go get more people hired.
Yeah. Let's see. I mean, a lot of the ones that I've really liked were people who are building products that are on blockchain technology, but they're hidden. They're like, hey, I want to build this or that on the Bitcoin protocol, but I don't want it to be known that it's built on that. And right. I think that's eventually like that will happen, and you kind of have this like, ha, you do like Bitcoin and you didn't even know it moment. Because I think it's one of those things that the technology really does kind of speaks for itself. I don't know if I want to put out specifics on anybody in case they are building it and I'm like become their worst
revealing it.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, really anything. Like one thing that's exciting for us is like the ability to disrupt like almost any industry is available. So you know, you can build, you know, the Twitter equivalent, or you know, Google Drive or Dropbox, or like some of that is being done now. But I think really like you can think of the product you use today, and like there's an opportunity to disrupt that in a sense, or at least make a you know, side product that makes sense. Maybe it's not, it doesn't have to be one or the other, but there's some really cool stuff going on.
Yeah, I think that one of the most interesting things about Bitcoin is that, one, we don't know who made it, right? Some guy named Satoshi Nakamoto, who's anonymous, made Bitcoin, and he's basically like Santa Claus, or like the Tooth Fairy or something. And that just is awesome to start. That's enough for me, actually. But then on top of that, we have this amazing technology, which is the blockchain, which enables both Bitcoin, the currency, but all these other things that we, so many things that we haven't even figured out, like what we could do.
Right.
It's like insane. And so you just kind of want to keep watching the industry and figuring out what's going on.
Yeah.
So if there's someone watching that either they have a Bitcoin company they're working on, or they will at some point, or maybe they're working somewhere, they are interested in working at a, you know, a Bitcoin company.
Yeah.
How should they get in touch with you to go do that?
Yeah. You can check us out on, it's honeybadger.com is the website. So basically we're like a double blind, kind of more high touch service. There are other cool, if you want to work in the space, Coinality was probably like the first one in the space, and their Bitcoin job board, and have more of like contract work. So I think we're more focused on like full-time roles at most of the companies we're working with are like VC-backed companies. But there's a lot of opportunity to kind of dabble on projects and that sort of thing. As far as like what companies are looking for, I think Bitcoin also offers a unique opportunity that when you think of other tech startups, like there's typically like a degree that makes sense, right? So we still don't have like the Bitcoin college degree. So a lot of it is there's an opportunity to just kind of dive in and like start playing around with the technology and start learning. That you kind of create your own degree, which I think is a cool opportunity. If you're in the Bay Area, we're frequently at a lot of the meetups, and it's one of those industries that's early enough that you'll meet founders at just about any meetup, people that are doing really cool things in the space. So, you know, I think that's another good route to go as well.
Maybe the requirement is if they've watched this entire Bitcoin course.
Yeah, yeah. Seriously, yeah. I think this will be something really cool. Like, there really is nothing like this out there. I love what you're doing with Zapchain. It's getting kind of telling a story there. That's actually my new go-to place if someone wants to learn about Bitcoin. I send them to some of the articles that have come out of Zapchain.
That's awesome. Yeah, go follow Derek on Zapchain.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, I'm excited to see the. I think in the next year or two, we're in this phase where there's a lot of really smart people with their heads down building cool stuff, and it's going to change quickly.
I think so too.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for helping us with this Bitcoin course.
Yeah, it's awesome.
I think that you know, talking to so many like super smart people that are already doing super smart things at really successful companies. And then they're going to go leave and do Bitcoin stuff. I think you have a super interesting perspective on the Bitcoin industry. Yeah,
and one, if anybody has any questions, I'm happy to, like, I'll try to get to you. I'm slowly getting unburied from email, but
can people tweet at you?
Yeah, tweet at me. It's Derek Minter.
@DerekMinter.
Very easy to find on the internet, so I stay on top of most mediums, but love having the conversation with anybody.
Cool. Awesome. Cool. All right. Bye, guys.
Thank you.